Alright, so new Glitch Pop skins just came out, and that made me thinking, are Valorant skins even worth buying? I'm Fatman, and today, if you want more Valorant content, be sure to leave a like, it's free, it supports my work, and I really appreciate you being here. But to look at it, Valorant skins just came out, and they're pretty big. Now, the Valorant Glitch Pop skins is something we wanted for a few months already, and it never came down to being out there. And finally, we can see more and more Valorant skins coming to Valorant. But does this mean you should buy every single skin you see? Well, first, we have to look at Glitch Pop. The Valorant devs simply outperformed themselves with such a skin. This is exactly what we needed in Valorant, and now they have finally delivered. I don't think any single skin can compete with Glitch Pop so far, being it simply beautiful. Now, I do think all of the skins are pretty. Now, if you have to choose for a specific skin on the Glitch Pop bundle, I would say Phantom or Vandal is the best, simply because you will use it the most. The knife is kind of what we have already. Now, what I really think you should look at is Ryan Miska's Glitch Pop review.
Yeah.
It almost feels still like you've got like a shell on it. Like game controller shells or like a Switch shell. It just like sort of adds to it, looks more robust, but looks much more powerful because of it. What's the Phantom like? Because I didn't really concentrate too much when that was in, so kind of a quick comparison between the two. And that, like, you've got the whole style of like Vandal being much more like edgier, being sharp, whereas the Phantom is just a lot more sleeker in design. And again, considering you're using the similar print.
I think it was a good move to implement like the classic Phantom and the Vandal,
and the
Operator as well. So I bought most of the bundles last year, but I stopped because I wanted to pick one and or the other. Like, I wasn't buying the complete bundle anymore, but this time it will be difficult for me.
It would be cool to see the old bundle go in as well. Like, you have this one coming out whenever, and then a week later you have the Glitch Pop one set, because I'm sure people will see this, love it, and be like, oh, I really want the Frenzy now that I've got like a full set, which I didn't get it. So
good point.
Can we have him kind of let it rip and you can hear the audio? I know I'm going on and off the audio, but I feel like the Vandal's very special. I'm not crazy about, like, I think Glitch Pop's well made. Aesthetically, it's not my type of thing, but the Vandal audio, I think, sells it.
Yeah, that sounds scary. Because the Prime Vandal is still kind of like a bit of a pew-pew, and it's kind of friendly in a way. I don't know. It's not as intimidating. But then this whole skin is like all colorful and, you know, really chaotic and out there. And then it just sounds like a murder machine.
It's supposed to be, right? Yeah. It's supposed to be like more dystopian. It's like happy on the outside, but like kind of messed up on the inside.
Yeah, that's really good.
So this can actually tell you a lot of things. They did mention each of its own skin having its own distinct feeling. Now, does that mean you should purchase every single skin you see? Well, not exactly, unless you're super duper rich. What's really important to note here is how many skins will you actually be using. Now, what I recommend you is, before you even buy skins in Valorant, is to actually check if you want them. Now, how I do that is I buy the battle pass and wait a month or two. And if after that I want those skins that have levels, that have unique animation effects, that are very special and used by pros, that's when I'm sure I want Valorant skins. Now, that is one option. The other option, other than considering just buying a battle pass and testing it out for yourself, seeing if you really want skins or not, is considering what type of skin do you want. Do you want a bundle? Do you only want a few specific skins? So, for example, the Glitch Pop skins I was talking about, and how the developers put very, very special effort into specific skins. Now, what's very important to note here is, when buying a skin, when you buy, for example, the Prime skin, it might feel that your aim got a bit better. And some people say it's a placebo effect, and it actually is. But simply put, it puts a little less of the recoil on the bottom left of the gun and makes you see the enemies easier. No, the skins aren't paid to win, but such a feature is very important to note when you're doing a firefight. Sometimes you improve when you buy a Vandal that's a $20 investment to get a better rank is a pretty good trade-off, I would say. Now let's look at the example how a prime skin sounds like. Prime bundle sounds so strong. If you ever used Prime Classic, for example, you can feel it more powerful. The laser sound has a nice bass layer, therefore the sound is thicker and your brain thinks it's stronger. Muscle cars are actually a great example of this effect. As for the Classic, I can use the Prime skin for the reasons I think are pretty good. Skins are worth buying, for example, if you play a Valorant a lot more. Now, it also resembles your financial status, as you can drop the skin to simply anyone in Valorant. Therefore, even if you have some friends that can't afford the skin or don't play enough Valorant, you can simply swap the weapon with them and have the skin for other people too. That's a great addition Valorant put in there that CSGO also had that simply makes skins much, much more worth it than, for example, in Overwatch games where you cannot share your skins. Now, yes, some skins are more expensive than others, and yes, you will be using only one set of skins. What's very important to also note here is you can't equip, for example, skins mid-game. If you ever owned a skin, you know how much this was of a hassle. But what's also important to note here, sometimes skins and multiple skins add more value to your game. Yes, some of these skins get quite expensive actually, but such is the way of life. With more expensive skins, you have different tiers, which I explain in my video. Valorant had a huge, huge problem with expensive skins in Valorant previously, but nowadays they actually offered cheap solutions to such prices. Either it be the night market, the specific skin you want, or more, there is no way you can't get the skin you want for pretty cheap. Considering that these skins are now the last of a price of a game, I'm pretty sure I'd say they are worth it, considering you play Valorant for more than 100 hours. Yes, there is something you should look into, and that is battle passes. They're really almost free. I mean, 13 euros, that's $15, is a price of a good meal. I guess that is pretty much worth it if you're playing Valorant for those 2 months. And to end this off, Valorant did tease something else I wanted to show you guys. Now, they didn't tell exactly what it is, but if you leave a like, it would help me out a lot, and I will be breaking that down.
This bundle will be live for 2 weeks, right?
Yes, this bundle is 2 weeks. And I'll leave you with this. There's something else happening, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We could stop record and then he could tell us a little bit.
No.
There's something else. I don't want to say because it's, you know, what if it doesn't happen? Nah. There might be something else.
Yeah. I mean, it's a surprise for us as well. So I'm looking forward to it.
Actually, yeah, two surprises, right?
I was going to say, the theme of all of this is like we're listening to what players want.
Yes,
and
yes.
It's taken a while for us to be able to react to some of the things and some of the things we wanted to do, right? But it just, again, takes a little bit. But we always listen. We always want to give players what they want and they'll be getting it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's like something to do with the skins, right? It's not. Like
Maybe, but kind of not. It's tangentially
Where's my shorty
related.
Buff? What the hell?
Shorty buff. Yeah, it's like short. Tangentially related. It's cosmetic related.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You'll see. You can go theorize on it.
And that's it for this time. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks again to Riot for allowing us to make this video. It's super cool to get a sneak peek. And until next time, take care. We'll see you then.